Welcome back, students. Now the chapter electric current and Ohm's law is theoretically over. As we have discussed about the effect of temperature on resistance, let us see graphically that what, before discussing this numerical, we'll see graphically what is the effect on resistance of different materials, you can say. Suppose this is resistivity here and here is temperature. So now let us make it for a metal, that is, so let us take an example, copper. So the graph will be in this way. For first some temperature, the resistance will constant be, and then it will be increasing. In this way the graph will come. For an alloy, it will be a straight line. Okay, and for a semiconductor, it will be inversely proportional. That is, if the resistance is increased, then the temperature, if the temperature is increased, then the resistance will decrease, or resistivity will decrease. It's just opposite. So in case of semiconductor, it's a rectangular hyperbola, you can say. In case of an alloy, it is a straight line, and in case of this metal, it increases, as we have seen, it increases by proportional to under root of temperature. So in this way it is there. Okay, so this is graphical representation. Now let us go to the question. The question says here that there is a bulb which is rated at 500 watt and 100 volt. So this is the maximum voltage that a bulb, this bulb can hold, 100 volt. And its power is 500 watt, and maximum voltage which it can bear is 100 volt. Now, it's connected to a circuit having 200 volt supply. Now this bulb which can bear only up to 100 volt is connected to a supply of 200 volt. So that means the voltage is more. So how much resistance should be put in series with this bulb so that it delivers 500 watt power? So in that case, let us assume that the resistance is R dash. Let this resistance R dash is connected in series with this bulb. Okay, and this entire thing is connected with 200 volt supply. Okay, so let us assume that the resistance is R of the bulb, and this bulb can bear only up to 100 volt. Okay, the rating of the bulb. So whatsoever the current is flowing through this battery will be same for this R dash and R. So if we talk about bulb, for bulb, we need to calculate resistance of the bulb. Okay. So since we have P is equal to V square by R, for bulb, the voltage is 100 volts. So R is equal to V square by P, that is 100 into 100 upon 500. So this will be cancelled out. This becomes 20. So R is equal to 20 ohms. So this R value is 20 ohm here. Okay, now what is the maximum current that the bulb can bear? So power is equal to V into I. So I is equal to P by V. That is 500 by 100 cancelled out. That is 5 ampere. So the value of I is 5 ampere. More than, if current more than this 5 ampere flows through this circuit, the bulb will collapse. It will, this filament will melt up. So it can't bear current more than this. So for this condition, we need to find out the value of R dash. So the total resistance is R plus R dash as they are in series. So I is equal to 200 upon R plus R dash. So R plus R dash is equal to 200 by 5. So let us calculate this up. This becomes 40. So R dash is equal to 40 minus R. So R dash is equal to 40 minus 20. So R dash is 20 ohms. That is, a resistance of 20 ohm is to be connected in series with this bulb so that this can operate at 200 volt supply and will deliver a power of 500 watt. Okay, I hope it is clear. Thank you.